Good morning, students. Can you hear my voice now? Okay, good morning. Okay, I think in the last class I started the problem in the form z equal to px plus qy equal to c into root of 1 plus p square plus p square. So this is Clairaut's form. It is z equal to px plus qy plus function of p. The complete solution is you should replace p by a and q by b. So equation 2 is the complete solution of equation 1. So for to get the singular solution for equation 1 for the given problem, so you need to differentiate partially equation 1 equation 2 with respect to a plus. You need to wait 1 hour, otherwise you'll give to this one come back. What is time now? What is time now? Okay, you can come on with me after 11. Okay. Okay, so you should differentiate partially with respect to a equation 2. You should differentiate partially with respect to a, and similarly you should differentiate equation 2 partially with respect to b, and you need to find the value of a and b in terms of x and y. Okay, so if you differentiate equation 2 partially with respect to a, you will get a 0 here ex plus c into root of a 1 plus a square plus b square. If you differentiate this, you will get 1 by 2 into root of 1 plus a square plus b square. If you differentiate 1 plus a square plus b square, you will get a 2a. 2a, 2 gets cancelled. You will get x is equal to minus ac divided by root of 1 plus a square plus b square. Okay. Similarly, if you differentiate equation 2 partially with respect to b, you will get this y. Okay, from x we will get a, from y we get b. Up to I think this step we solved in the previous class. Now I am going to squaring x square and y square, and I am going to add these two. So x square plus y square will give you x square plus y square equal to, please check it, a square c square plus b square c square whole divided by 1 plus a square plus b square. So now c square minus of x square plus y square is equal to c square minus x square plus y square is a square c square plus b square c square divided by 1 plus a square plus b square. So if you take LCM, one plus a square plus b square, so you will get c square into c square plus c square a square plus c square e square minus a square c square minus b square c square. So after cancelling this, you will get c square. Left hand side is what? C square minus x square minus y square is equal to c square divided by 1 plus a square plus b square. So actually I need 1 plus a square plus b square. So 1 plus a square plus b square is equal to c square divided by c square minus x square minus y square. Okay. Now I think what is x? Please tell what is x. The previous slide you have x
minus ac.
Minus ac by root of
root of 1 plus a square plus b square.
1 plus a square plus b square. From this we obtained a. What is, I will write here, okay, what is a? A equal to minus x into root of 1 plus a square plus b square divided by c. So a equal to minus x by c. What is root of 1 plus a square plus b square? C divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. After cancelling this c and c, a equal to minus x divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. So this is a. Similarly, we need to get b. Next slide will go to next. So what is b? Okay, I write in the two slides before, b equal to minus, please check it, minus y into root of 1 plus a square plus b square divided by c. So this is equal to minus y by c. Root of 1 plus a square plus b square is c divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. So after cancelling c and c, you will get b equal to minus y divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. So this is your b. So now I am going to substitute the value of a and b in the complete solution. What is the complete solution? Equation number 2, you can check it. Substitute the values of a and b in equation 2. So equation 2 is z equal to ax plus by plus c into root of 1 plus a square plus b square. So what is a? A equal to, please check it, a equal to minus x by root of c square minus x square minus y square minus x divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. This is a into x. B is minus y divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square into y plus c into root of 1 plus a square plus b square is what? Anybody? Root of 1 plus a square plus b square?
C square divided by c square minus x square minus b square.
Yeah, you are correct. That is 1 plus a square plus b square. So if you take root, you will get c divided by root of c square minus x square minus y square. Okay, I think the denominator is the same, so I'll take denominator is root of c square minus x square minus y square. So the numerator is, I'll write first this term c square, and then I'll write this term minus y square minus x square. I'll write this term minus x square, and then finally I'll write this one minus y square. So this is the form x by root x. So this is equal to root of c square minus x square minus y square. The left hand side is z. If you're squaring on both sides, you will get z equal to, sorry, z square equal to c square minus x square minus y square. The final answer is z square plus or x square plus y square plus z square equal to c square. So which is the singular solution of equation 1, that is a given problem. The singular solution of equation 1. Okay, so okay, now I'm going to give one more problem, last problem in Clairaut's form, and then I'll go to type 3. So here I am going to just give the outline of this problem. I am not going to solve the whole problem. Solve z equal to px plus qy plus p square plus pq plus q square. So this is equation number 1. So I think this is of the form Clairaut's form. In Clairaut's form only you have everything, that is you have x, y, z and p, q. Okay, and it's also form is of the form px plus qy plus function of p, q, that is p square plus p, q plus q square is function of p, q. Okay, you should write this is the Clairaut's type equation. Okay, now the complete solution of equation 1. You write short form, complete solution of equation 1, z equal to ax plus by plus a square plus ab plus b square. This is equation 2. Okay, differentiate equation 2 partially with respect to A and partially with respect to B to get the singular solution. So differentiate equation 1. partially with respect to A, you get 0 equal to x plus 2a plus b. So this is equation 3. Similarly, differentiate equation 2. Differentiate equation 2 partially with respect to b, you will get 0 equal to y plus a plus 2b. This is equation 4. So we need to solve equation 3 and 4. So for each problem, I used some different techniques. So depending upon the situation, we need to adapt. We need to use the techniques. Okay, now solving equation 3 and 4 for A and B. Solving equation 3 and 4 for A and B. So from 3, we have B equal to minus x minus 2a. Now I am going to substitute the value of b in equation 4. So 4 implies, what is 4? 0 equal to r y plus a plus 2 into b. What is b? B is minus x minus 2a equal to 0. So from this we have y plus a minus 2x minus 4a equal to 0. So I need a, okay, because already we have b. So what is a? Minus 3a minus 3a equal to 2x minus y, or a equal to y minus 2x by 3. Now substitute the value of a here. So if you substitute the value of a here, you will get b. So since b equal to x minus, sorry, minus x minus 2a minus x minus 2a. So this is equal to minus x minus 2 into, just now I got the value of a. A is what? Y minus 2x divided by 3. Okay. If take 3 is LCM, minus 3x minus 2y plus 4x divided by 3. So this is your b. So b equal to, we simplify further, we'll get x minus 2y divided by 3. This is x minus 2y divided by 3. So now you need to substitute a value and b value in equation 2. So z equal to what? The complete solution. Z equal to ax plus by plus a square plus ab plus b square. So what is a? A is y minus 2x by 3 into x, plus b is x minus 2y by 3 into y, plus a square. A square is y minus 2x by 3 whole square. Y minus 2x. To check it, it is a square plus ab, okay. So y minus 2x whole square by 3 square. 3 square is 9 plus a into b. A into b, 1 by 3 into 1 by 3, 1 by 9 into a is here on y minus 2x, here x minus 2y. And finally, b square. So b square is x minus 2y. Well, it's a relief. Attestation or the class, sorry. Class on the two, no, Ronaldo Murjuno. 45 minutes of Murjuno. One, I'll go on. Ah, one. Yeah, number one out for 9 9 7 6 9 6 9 9 7 6 9 6 4 9 5 1. Okay, well, thank you. Okay, sorry. B square is x minus 2y whole square. X minus 2 whole square by 3 square. 3 square is 9. So I leave this part to you. You need to simplify further because it will take time. But it is just computational. So I'll give the final answer also. You can check the final answer. The final answer is right here. 3z plus x square plus y square minus xy equal to 0. So this is the singular solution of this problem. Okay. So I'll give a practice problem. This type. So you need to solve at least one or two problems. Otherwise, it's a little bit difficult in the examination. So try to solve z equal to px plus qy plus q by p minus p. So you can easily see that this is the form z equal to px plus qy plus function of t comma q. Second problem, solve pq minus p minus q into z minus px minus qy equal to pq. First problem you can easily identify. What about the second problem? I think this is Clairaut's form. Can you, if you rewrite this, the given problem, you can get it. So anyone of you tell how to rewrite? Okay, first I will give the answer for the, yeah, please tell.
PQ by?
Very good. PQ divided by?
PQ minus P minus Q is equals to?
Is equal to, I'll write here, is equal to?
Z minus PX minus QY.
Z minus PX minus QY, okay. And then?
Now Z equals to? PQ by PQ minus P minus Q plus?
Yeah, first you can write PX plus QY. Yeah, your answer is also correct. I'll write in the order, okay? Okay, very good. Thank you. So now this is the form z equal to px plus qy plus function of pq. So you know how to find the complete solution, and then you need to find a singular solution. So for the first problem, the answer is answer for the first problem is yz equal to 1 minus x. So I am just telling the singular solution only. For a second problem, the answer is z equal to 1 plus root x plus root y whole square. So this is also a singular solution for this problem. Okay, you can try these two problems. Now I am going to type number 3. So I know that I am going a little bit slowly. Okay, but I want to solve some more problems, then only you can understand clearly each and every type. Later I will go, once you understand the concept, and then I will go a little bit fast. Type number 3. So in type 3, there are 3 types of equations. I will write you. One is a function of z comma p comma q equal to 0. Another one is x comma p comma y equal to 0, and y comma p comma q equal to 0. So at least I want to try to finish type 3 today. Okay. So I told that x, y, here x, y is missing. Missing means it is not explicitly shown. Similarly here, on the second one, x and y and z are not explicitly here. Similarly here, x and z are not present explicitly. Okay. So we know that p equal to dou z by dou x, and q equal to dou z by dou y. Okay. So directly I go to the problem. First problem. Solve p into 1 plus q equal to qz. So I'll take the given problem is equation 1. So you can easily see that here you have pq and z. Pq and z. So this is comes under type 3. Okay. Now to get the solution of these types of equation, you should assume the solution of this equation 1 is, let us assume the solution of equation 1 is z equal to function of u, where u equal to x plus ay. Maybe somebody will assume u equal to ax plus y. So that is also correct. So x and y are in linear. So again, I'll repeat. To get the solution of equation 1, you need to assume the solution of equation 1 is of the form z equal to f of u, where u is linear in x and y, where a is the arbitrary constant. Okay. Now I'll write p equal to dou z by dou x. So you know that dou z by dou x. Now z is a function of u, that's why z is a function of u, that's why I'll write dou z by dou u, and then dou u by dou x. Okay. So this is equal to dou z by dou u, I'll keep as it is. What is dou u by dou x? Because u equal to x plus ay, dou u by dou x is 1. Since dou u by dou x is equal to 1. So left hand side is what? P, this implies p equal to dou z by dou u. Okay. Now similarly q equal to dou z by dou y. And again, z is a function of u. So differentiate z with respect to u and u with respect to x. Y. So this is equal to dou z by dou u. Dou u by dou y is a. Okay, you can write the reason. Dou u by dou y equal to a. So from this we have q equal to a into dou z by dou u. Okay. So now I am going to substitute the value of p and q in equation 1, because z, you are assuming z equal to f of u is a solution of equation 1. So we got these two from z equal to f of u. So it should satisfy the equation 1. Since z equal to f of u is a solution of equation 1, these two should satisfy equation 1. So now I am going to substitute p equal to dou z by dou u and q equal to a into dou z by dou u in equation 1. Okay. So equation 1 implies, please check it. Actually, p is what? Dou z by dou u. Okay. I write again p into 1 plus q equal to qz. I think you know what is p. P is dou z by dou u into 1 plus q. Q is a into dou z by dou u is equal to q. Q is a into dou z by dou u into z. Now actually z is a function of u only, so that's why I'm going to replace the partial derivative by the ordinary derivative. So if you replace partial derivative by ordinary derivative, you have dz by du into 1 plus a into dz by du equal to az into dz by du. So okay, now if I take dz by du commonly, what is remaining? A into, okay, yeah, if I take dz by du commonly, you have a into dz by du minus az plus 1 equal to 0. So either a into b equal to 0. So either a equal to 0 or b equal to 0. Actually, this is not equal to 0 because z is not constant. Okay, z is not a constant. So that's why this is not equal to 0, and hence this should be 0. So a into dz by du minus az plus 1 equal to 0. Or you can write a into dz by du equal to az minus 1. So from this, dz by du equal to az minus 1 by a. So variable separable method. Okay, so variable separable method, z one side, u one side. Okay, now I'm going to write dz by az minus 1 equal to du. So in the next step, I'm going to write a into dz by az minus 1 equal to du. So integrating, you will get integrating, you get a into integration of dz by az minus 1 equal to integration of du plus b, some arbitrary constant b. So you'll get a into you'll get log of az minus 1, because if you differentiate log of az minus 1 you will get 1 by az minus 1, and then if you differentiate z you'll get a. So this a is here, so including this a I'll got this value. Okay, this is equal to integration of du is u plus b. Okay, now we know that u equal to x plus ay. Okay, so that is log of az minus 1 equal to u equal to x plus ay plus b, where a and b are arbitrary constants. Arbitrary constants. So complete solution of equation 1 is, actually this is the complete solution of equation 1. Okay, I'll finally write complete solution of equation 1, that is a given problem, is log of az minus 1 equal to x plus ay plus b. So okay, if you want to find the general solution, so I gave the procedure in type 1. So usually what you'll do to find it, I'll tell the idea, you need to replace b by what? F of a, you need to replace b by f of a, and then differentiate that equation partially with respect to a. Okay, you'll get one equation. So you should eliminate a from this equation and from that equation, you will get the general solution. Just you need to write that one. Okay, so for this for type 3, complete solution is enough. Okay, suppose if you want to find the general solution, this is the method. So I don't want to waste my time to find the general solution. Similarly, for type 3, singular solution is not possible. Okay, suppose, because if you differentiate this with respect to a, okay, for if you differentiate with respect to a, no problem. If you differentiate with respect to b partially, then the left hand side is 0, right hand side is 1. So 0 equal to 1, so which is not possible, and hence you can't find the singular solution. To find the general solution, I gave the method. You should take b equal to f of a, and you should differentiate partially with respect to a, you will get one more equation. So you take, this is equation 2, and the resulting equation after substituting b equal to f of a, you take, that is 3. Okay, and you need to differentiate partially equation 3 with respect to a, you will get equation 4. You should eliminate a between 3 and 4, you will get general solution. So this is the idea of general solution and a singular solution. Okay, so next I am going to solve the second problem in type 3. Okay, solve 9 into PQ into z power 4 equal to 4 into 1 plus z cube. So let us take, this is given equation 1. The given problem is equation 1. Okay, you can easily see that it contains z, p, q. Okay, so as I told that you should take the solution of this equation is of the form z equal to f of u, where u equal to x plus ay. And in the previous problem, I explained how to get p and q, but you can write directly p equal to, what is p? Anyone from, what is p?
Dou z by dou u.
Yes, good. But finally, we will replace by what? Dz by du, because z is a function of u only. So instead of p, you should replace by dz by du, and q by a into dz by du. Okay. So now equation 1 implies 9 into pq. Pq is dz by du. Q is a into dz by du is equal into z power 4 is equal to 4 into 1 plus z cube. Okay, now dz by du whole square is equal to 4 by 9 into 1 plus z cube divided by a into z power 4. So now from this, what is dz by du? Dz by du equal to 2 by 3 into root of 1 plus z cube divided by root a. I'll write root a here. Root a into z square. Okay, now this is dz by du. So now variable separable method. So z one side, u one side. So d is z square into dz divided by root of 1 plus z cube is equal to 2 into du divided by 3 root a. Okay, I will write in the next slide. So z square into dz by 1 plus z cube equal to 2 by 3 into root a into d. Okay, now integrating on both sides, you will get integrating z square by root of 1 plus z cube into dz equal to 2 by 3 into root a into integration of du plus some arbitrary constant b. So let us take, we need to integrate the left hand side. Let us take 1 plus z cube equal to some t. So 3 into z square dz equal to dt. So from this z square dz equal to dt by 3. Now integration z square dz is dt by 3 divided by 1 plus z cube is t, so root t, that is t power half, okay, is equal to 2 by 3 into root a if integration of d is u plus b. Okay, now this is equal to 1 by 3 integration of dt by t power half is okay, you'll write one more step. If you want to write t power minus half into dt 2 by 3 into 1 by root a into u plus b. Okay, if you integrate this, you'll get, okay, 3 gets cancelled. So t power half divided by 1 by 2, that is 2 into root t. Integrate t power minus half. So this is equal to 2 into divided by 2u divided by root a plus b. So now the final answer is you need to replace t by 1 plus z cube. So 2 into root of 1 plus z cube equal to 2 divided by root a into u. What is u? U is x plus a y plus b. So you can stop here. So which is a complete solution of equation 1. Complete solution of equation 1. So here I will give some practice problem. Okay, and okay, you will try to solve this problem. So first problem, 9 into p square z plus q square equal to 4. Second problem, z equal to p square plus q square. Third problem, p into 1 minus q square equal to q into 1 minus z. So in all the three problems you have p, q, z. Now I solved only type 3 first part, that is a function of z p q. So next I'm going to solve the problem from x p q. Okay, problems from function of x p q. This is also comes under type 3. Okay, so third problem, solve q equal to px plus p square. So here you have x, p, q. So if you have this type x, p, q, you should assume q equal to a. Okay. Suppose if you have function of y, p, q, you should assume p equal to a. So equation 1 implies where a is a arbitrary constant. 1 implies a equal to px plus p square. Now rewrite this, you get p square plus px minus a equal to 0. So solve this equation for p, we get, this is a quadratic equation p, so p equal to minus b minus x plus or minus root of b square. B square is what? X square minus 4ac. A is 1, c is minus a, so plus a divided by 2 into 1, 2. So you will get a p value. Now to get the complete solution, consider dz equal to p dx plus q dy. So this implies dz equal to, so p is minus x plus or minus root of x square plus 4a divided by 2 into dx plus q is a into dy. Now if you integrate, you will get the final answer. I'll write the next slide. So if integrating you get integration dz left hand side, the right hand side is minus x, minus x dx, okay, minus denominator is you have 2, so minus 1 by 2 x dx plus or minus again 1 by 2 integration root of x square plus 4a into dx plus a into integral dy plus b. So this is equal to z equal to x square by 2, so minus x square by 4 plus or minus 1 by 2 is common. So this is the formula for root of x square plus a square. Root of x square plus a square is integration is x by 2 into x by 2 into root of x square plus a square, that is x square plus a square is 4a plus a square is 4a, a square by 2 divided by 2 into sin h inverse of x by a. What is a? A square equal to 4a means a equal to 2 root a. Plus b. Plus b. So actually, if you want to simplify, you can simplify further. I think this is enough. Z equal to minus x square by 4 plus 1 by 2 into x by 2 into root of x square plus 4a. Okay. Otherwise, you can multiply by this 2 here. Okay. This is a complete. I think I missed one term here. I think I missed a into y plus a into y plus b, which is the complete solution of equation 1. And the last problem, problem number 4. So this is comes under the type function of sign function of y comma p comma q, function of x comma p comma q and the function of y comma p comma q is comes under only 2 mark question. Function of z comma p comma q may come big question. Okay, now solve pq equal to y. So this is our form f of y comma p comma q. So as you told already, solution of this problem, we should assume p equal to a. If p equal to a, equation 1 implies, equation 1 implies aq equal to y. This implies q equal to y by a. So now consider dz equal to pdx plus qdy. So p is what? A. Q is y by a. Now integrating, you will get integration of dz equal to a into integration of d plus 1 by a integration of y into dy plus some constant b. So this implies z equal to ax plus y square by 2 square by 2a you integrate this plus b, which is a complete solution of equation 1. So now type 4. So type 4 is a separable equation. Type 4 is separable equation. So actually this is a first order PDE. Is said to be separable if it can be written as f of x comma p equal to some function of y comma q. Okay. So here you have x, y, p, q, but p, x is combined with p and y is combined with q. I am going to solve the last problem. Solve p square plus q square equal to x square plus y square. So take this is 1. So you can easily see that you can easily group p and x separately and q and y separately. There is no z here. This type, there is no z. So p square minus x square equal to y square minus q square. So let us take this is equal to some a square. So from this p square equal to a square plus x square. So p equal to root of a square plus x square. Similarly, q square equal to what? Y square plus a square. Y square minus a square, q square equal to y square minus a square. So q equal to root of y square minus a square. So now to find the solution, you should consider dz equal to pdx plus q dy. So substitute the value of p and q here. So dz equal to p is the root of a square plus x square into dx. Q is root of y square minus a square into dy. So now integrating. So integral dz equal to integral root of a square plus x square dx plus integral root of y square minus a square into dy. So now we should know the formulas. So z equal to, left hand side is z equal to root of x square plus a square is x by 2 root of x square plus a square or a square plus x square plus a square by 2 into sine h inverse of x by a. Otherwise you can write in terms of logarithm also. Okay, log of x plus root of x square plus a square plus integration root of y square minus a square is y by 2 into root of y square minus a square minus a square by 2 into cos h inverse of y by a plus d. So which is the complete solution of equation 1. Is a complete solution of equation 1, that is a given problem. So practice problem in type 4. First problem, p minus x square equal to q plus y square and 2 p square plus q square equal to x plus y and root p plus root q equal to x plus y and finally p square y into 1 plus x square equal to q x square. Okay, thank you. So I take today 5 more minutes. I know that ICT students are very good, so that's why I take five more minutes. I know if you have any doubt, you can ask to me now. Otherwise, you can ask in the WhatsApp group also. So try to solve these problems. If possible, we can post the answer in our group, or if you have any doubt, you can ask in the group through WhatsApp. Okay, thank you.